Hello everybody, GrayStillPlays, and I'm here with a new game for the channel that I really wanted to show you guys. The name of this game is called Eden Star, and the type of game that this is, if I had to describe it, is almost like a very fast-paced survival building, base building, almost first-person shooter turret defense game with some parkour and some aliens mixed in. There's a lot of things happening in this game. It's very interesting. The classification of the game progress is considered pre-alpha, but I gotta tell you, there's a lot more to this game than what I would consider a pre-alpha game. The game is very solid so far, and the thing I like the most about it is that the development team is incredibly diligent in continuing to make updates and having developer blogs about the roadmap of the game. So that's kind of one of the reasons I'm really interested in this game. And of course, it's base building, survival, kind of blowy uppy game. So that's the kind of stuff I love anyway. The beginning screen here that you're treated with after you start a new game is the deployment screen. Very reminiscent to like Ark Survival Evolved, I would say. Now, they just had a very large update in this game. So the map size became, I forget, it's much, much larger than it was. I think like 16 times larger than it was. And there's a lot of new things that you can build and new enemies and things of that nature. They just made a big update and they're planning on making more. So very interesting. We have to pick one of these places to go ahead and start in. I'm going to pick the Northern Reach. That just sounds cool. So we're going to go ahead and deploy there. And once we're in, I'll kind of describe more of the game as I play. Okay, so here we are in the game. You can see the game pretty crisp, looking very good. The way the game works is a little bit more, I don't know, like kind of interesting when it comes to the gathering of materials and such. You right click to destroy different items and your guy like breaks the items down with this amazing palm of power he has. And when the items break down, they drop different resources. Like you can see as I hover over this tree here, it'll say fiber, protonite, root, and all that type of deal. Now, the protonite is why I'm harvesting these trees, because the protonite is very valuable for making all of the different turrets and structures and everything else that we're going to make inside of this game. So we're really going to want that. On the left side of the screen, you can see everything that I'm picking up, like fiber, protonite, vesicles. those are all very important as well. We need to think about an area where we want to make our base. In general, from what I found, making a base close to like a cliff or something where the enemies can only attack you from one side is a very good idea. So attacking an enemies in this game, let me go into that real briefly. And I am no expert at this game, but again, the game is like pre-alpha, so... Well, they say it's pre-alpha. I think it's a little bit more down the line than that. It looks pretty damn good. So, the way this game works is if in the upper left-hand corner, you can see that clock ticking down. And if you notice, it is in seconds. Although, think of it more like time, like, moving very, very quickly. That is the daylight timer. When the daylight is gone, horrible, horrible creatures come out in the night. And you need to have a base built and defenses prepared to deal with those creatures. Otherwise, you're going to get freaking nuked. And it's not going to be good. And you will be very, very unhappy. So that's why right now, I am harvesting the entire time while I'm trying to also talk about this game. So we've gotten a lot of protonite, which is good. I probably want to get almost 50 of that. We need some rock structures too. Right here, you're going to see Bridgmanite. Think of that like your most standard kind of... like rocky ore, like almost granite or something in this game. You know, mid-level strong, maybe a little brittle, very, very common. You can find this crap everywhere. And this is very good for building the basic structures in the game, meaning like your floors and your ceilings and your walls and things of that nature, because you can find it everywhere. Now, some of the things that we're specifically looking for is going to be a different colored rock. It looks kind of like a green glowing rock. And that's even stronger of like a substance to make things with. And that's what we're going to want to make our turrets out of. The big issue is I just have to find it. Now, this little hand module that I have, this is just the beginning. Understand, and if you look down in the bottom middle of the screen, You're going to see modules, weapons, and consumables. There's a lot of different ways that you can upgrade this thing to do more damage, to hit a larger area, all kinds of stuff. You can also do like little kind of like climbing parkour stuff now and again. You can run up walls and stuff. I'm just not very good at it. That is a large cliff face over there. I'm just kind of taking a look at the map real quick. Map with M as usual. Now, beyond being able to harvest stuff with our hand of greatness here, we can also fight with this. Not only can you get, you know, your standard weapons like rifles and submachine guns and all there have you in the game, you can also, I don't know, like almost use telekinetic powers with this hand. Almost like suspend gravity in there have you, and you can throw stuff in the air. If we find a little critter or something, I'll show you guys what that's like. So that is a really, really big cliff face. I don't know if I want to build quite that far over. Usually if we stay near a water source, you can find some good stuff, some more plants over here, get some pulp. That'll give us some drink. We need food as well. There's a little critter up here. I'll see if I can snag him real fast. There we go. See how we have him like this? Now we can smash him into the ground and take him out. He'll drop a little meat chunk there, and we can use that for food. So, turret defense style game, like I was saying. So you make your base, and you want your base to be heavily defensible, but you don't just have to let your base do everything. You can help your base out, and that's kind of what I love about this game. How not only can you make a cool base and, you know, your base will protect you, but you can get in there and mix it up with your base as well. I think that's really neat. Got a large cliff. Oh, here we go. This is what we're looking for right here. Tunnel. That's what this is called. And this is just a much harder, stronger style of like rare material. Well, rarer material on the board than what we typically find. Now, think about your palm, like, breaking the stuff down. See how it falls afterward? You have to grab it. If you just break it all down and you don't spend any time picking any of this up, then you won't get the materials. So, you can see we already have about 32 tunnel. That's pretty good. Since this tree is here, I'll go... Oh, we got something coming at us. Right here. We have a couple of melee weapons, too. Let's go throw him out of here. See how we used our little handy thing there to, like, toss him across the other side of the board. Oh, we got another one right here. You can throw them up into the air or throw them against trees, too. Since this guy decided to mess with us, we'll beat the living crap out of him. There we go. Give us your morsels, you bastard. I don't think he had any morsels on him. Go ahead and grab... Oh, there we go. There's some morsels. Got a lot more tunnel over here, too. Let's grab all this tunnel. I like to put my base on the high ground. So that's what I'm really looking for right now. This cliffside is good, but you can see we have a big uphill battle here. We do want to be close to resources, though, just like this tunnel. That will help. We have about 9 minutes here to build a base, though, so we got to keep going, man. And I do want to get some base building done for you guys, just to kind of show you that as well. And we'll go through the night here and get attacked by those aliens. Now, the attacks become bigger and more impressive, I do believe, as you continue your game. So in the beginning here, we're going to be getting, you know, like, air quotes, the easiest opponents that we can get. Oh, this is interesting. This is a little odd area here. It looks like we've got some sort of liquid here, but it doesn't show up. Now, I don't know if this is a graphical problem with mine, or if this is a graphical problem with the game right now. But that's kind of like, you know, the alpha type of deal it is right here. I'm trying to grab some of this too. I'm not really sure that we're finding any of it. Oh, we got some eels or something coming at us. Let's get out of here. I'd rather just not deal with that right now. We can get some more tunnel and stuff because I saw a ton of it over here. 58 tunnel, 109 bridgmanite. We're going to need a lot more than that though, I can tell you. I'm going to want at least one turret up, probably two though. I think the turrets require like 30 tunnel. So we do have quite a bit of tunnel here. A lot more though hanging around though, so this is great. Now if we go straight ahead, oh, you can see there's little space deers kind of wandering around here as well. Kind of just looking at us sideways. Now if we go up this hill, and I'll look at the map in a moment, if we can get to the edge of, what was this called, the Onyx Shelf? I think that's where I'm going to want to be. Let's take a look here. Yeah, if we just head straight up this way, and this is a really good place for resources over here, it looks like. There is a ton of stuff. There's more tunnel over there. Now, there's little pods over here as well that you can find, like, seeds and stuff. You can smash these on the ground. And you'll see, right there, you see that? That's plasma fire. Those are other items that you can use to make a lot of weaponry in the game. I'm gonna go and grab a little bit more protonite, just because the protonite is always very valuable. Especially if we can... especially if we can get, like, maybe 50 protonite. That would be great. I'll go break this down here. More fiber. Not really any protonite that we're getting. More seeds? Seeds are fine. Oh, Jesus! Well, you know how it is. Every once in a while. There we go. 30 protonite. Not bad. 31 protonite. 33. If you kind of stand into the tree like this, you can kind of, like, blast through it in one shot here. You see how we're doing it with our hand? Instead of going the long way. 35 protonite. Alright, not bad. It usually takes about 1 protonite per object in order to make anything. Let's go ahead and take a look real quick here. Okay, so up this way, back to the onyx shelf. On our way over, I'm gonna keep getting this tunnel. This way we can continue to get additional bridgmanite and additional tunnel right here. You can do a lot for your base in this game, though. I would say right now, the base building portion of it is probably the largest portion. And so if you love base building style games, this is something else. I'll tell you what. Ah, some Capri Nuts. Capri Nuts give you a lot of hunger back. So they are good to have. In fact, I'm gonna break all these down looking for those nuts. If we can get some, I would really appreciate it. The vesicles do give you, I think, a little bit of food and drink as well. But it's just not as good as the nuts. Give me your nuts, damn it. Yep, every once in a while, you gotta head into the wild and play with some nuts. You know how it is. Continuing over here to the cliffside. Man, there's a lot of these plants hanging around here. I'm gonna let those kind of go for the moment. More space deer is kind of lingering. You can see right there. If you notice at the bottom left, there are several kind of meters that we're looking at here. We've got a stamina meter, we have a health meter. And then we have an O2 meter, a drink meter, and a food meter. And all those are important to watch, because if we let those get out of hand, it's not good. Oh, we seem to be getting close to the ridgeline. See that red chunk right there? That red chunk is a nest. So the other issue is that we don't want to be too close to a nest. Ooh, we actually blew ourselves up really bad there. Holy crap. I didn't think about that. The damage those things do is very, very good. You can see right over there is that nest. Let's see how close we are to the shoreline here. We're getting closer. And there's other blue beams that you'll eventually see in the game. And those blue beams are for bases that you can find and you can kind of harvest things from. Just looking around to see what other resources we have in the area. Go ahead and climb up here. There we go. There's a little climbing mechanic. If you sprint at something, it will allow you to climb up it. And right over here should be a decent place for our base. It's not super close to the tunnel, but we can get there in probably about, I don't know what, say a minute or so. I don't want to build too close to everything. Oh, look at this critter right over here. Big old guy over there having a good time. A lot of bridgmanite here, so that's good. We can build a lot of simplistic structures with that. And we can probably do some more looking at stuff on the coastline here in a little bit. A lot more bridgmanite there. That's good. It's impressive. This ridge was actually a lot further over than I had previously anticipated. Okay, so this is the edge of our ridge. We can start a little bit of a build here. I think that's what we'll probably go ahead and do. Now, to build, it's Q. And you can see the very first thing that we can build is a Eden kit. And you can click on your middle mouse button to cycle through. If you notice the right hand side, it says categories. You can cycle through your categories there, and then you can scroll the middle mouse button to look at the different items within the categories. And then if you hold down CTRL and scroll wheel, it'll show you the different types. So you can see tunnel there is the strongest, ironite second strongest, and those are the two items that we can build things out of. I think that we're going to go ahead, it would take 20 tunnel for that. We're just going to do ironite for this. Now we want to make sure that we get as much energy from this as possible. You can see how there's like a pulsing field that comes out from this. And we want it to just about go to the edge of the ridgeline there. So let's go ahead and put this thing right there with the left mouse button. There we go. So now we have a Eden kit online. You can see right there, it's firing into the sky, so to speak. And now we can go ahead and build like the rest of our area here. We're gonna need some. Let me just check to see. Okay, good. This went right out just barely to the edge of the line there. Let's go and do, we're going to need foundations, and we can start building some foundations. You can build it out of fiber there, which obviously is the weakest. Tennel, very strong, but you can see how many, we'll run out of resources if we do that. So I like to build this stuff out of Brigmanite. Brigmanite, it's strong, it's fine, it'll do well for us. Go ahead and just kind of build some floor pieces here. These floor pieces will be integral because we'll be able to build defenses on top of them. Now, when you start building items that require power, you can see how quickly we're burning through our protonite doing this, by the way. That's why you want to be fairly close to areas that you can get protonite in. So we have some trees here that we can use for some protonite, and I'm going to do that right now, as a matter of fact. I'm going to see if we can get some 75% protonite on these trees. That's not bad. You can see right there, we're already up to 5. These little trees seem to give protonite pretty damn good. There's a lot of those giant, freaky cow creatures wandering around. I don't really know what the hell those things are, but they are, they're something else, man. Big old tree over here. Don't mind going ahead and ripping this down for some potential protonite. That's for damn sure. Back up to 16 protonite. Very good. That'll be able to get us at least a little bit more flooring done. You can see we have a minute and 22 seconds left, so we are going to have to get this done big time. I want my flooring here to be equal, though, everywhere that I can make it. Let's see here. Cannot build just because that's kind of going up the ways there. That's fine, though. And we'll put, let's see, I want to get this out as far as I can. One piece here, here, and here. You can extend these, I do believe, to get some height on them. You can also build pillars and then, like, build on top of the pillars. So that's fine, too. Keep the Brigmanite going. There we go. We've got 6 left. And you can see here, we're almost out of the range of our Eden kit, so I don't want to go any further. Let's see here. For the foundations, let's actually stay on foundations, and let's do a... There should be, let me see here, maybe under primitive. I know one of these has a pillar. There we go, a nice Brigmanite pillar. Let's go ahead and get one of those down. And we'll put a Brigmanite pillar right over here as well. And now let's put down some defenses. You can see 14 seconds, man. We need to get there freaking quick. Hold on. A nice Ironite auto turret. I don't want that out of Ironite. Let's make it out of... Tennel. Oh, wow. It needs 15 protonite. All right, guys. This is going to be close, man. The darkness has come, which means that we are going to get creatures coming in right now. You can see already some weird stuff happening around here. I don't know if you saw that in the distance. There was, like, some really weird objects flying around there. Oh, boy. Come on, baby. Get that protonite done. I should have had this done way ahead of time. Oh, crap. There we go. Let's get him out of here real fast. 14 pieces of protonite. We need at least one more. And go ahead over here to these trees real fast. Come on, baby. Give me that protonite. Okay, good. We have a piece of protonite. Let's get this turret down. Oh, there we go. Yes! That's what we wanted. That's what we wanted. We're gonna pick this up right here, that piece of cartilage right there. You can see there's a couple of other just creatures wandering about. Let's go ahead and see if we can get some more protonite. We need 15 more in order to make another turret. And I would really like to get out of the way. And I would really like to have 2 turrets if at all possible. Oh yeah, baby. Turrets are doing it to it, man. Right over there. Oh, give me that freaking protonite. 5 pieces of protonite. Gonna need plenty more than that, though. Luckily, like I said, our turret taking care of business while we're doing this. Now, the game has changed a little bit. It used to be where if you were outside while you were doing this, you were constantly getting injured. It doesn't look like that's the case anymore, though. We need to be cognizant as well of anything that might attack us in the area. I can hear some things moving around, man. Let's see. Another tree over here. Let's see. Oh, right there. We got some guys incoming. Get you out of here. Send those right toward the turrets. This way the turrets can take care of business. We got about 3 minutes that we have to survive. I'm hoping to get that secondary piece of turret up before we run out of time here. Come on, baby. Give me that protonite, man. We were hitting the protonite package big time before, and now we're not getting jack crap. Let's see here. 13 pieces still. Oh, come on. Give me the protonite. Get you out of the way. Still 13 protonite, man. Okay, this is good. Hold on. We want them to explode. Because we can get all these little plasma fires here. You can see they are blowing up. But, oh, get him out of the way. Let's start heading back to our turret. Actually, I'm going to break this down right here. One more of these. See if I can get some additional protonite. Oh, boy. Get up out of here, boy. 15 pieces. We got it, man. Let's get the hell out of here. Oh, get to the turrets. Get to the choppers. Crap. Building constructed. There we go. Now we're set, baby. You can see right here, this poor auto turret has got quite a bit of damage to it. We need a lot more. There's a lot more structures that we have to make, though, in order to be able to do repairs, though. Excellent shots there. Now that we have these two turrets, though, we should be doing a lot better. I also need to get some energy back, so let's go into our inventory here by pressing I. You can see we have some morsels and some stuff, some plasma fire. Oh, Jesus! Whoa, whoa, whoa! Whoa! Whoa, we got all kinds of guys coming in here. Let's grab that plasma fire as we get it, though. All this plasma fire, all that we can grab. Because if we let it blow up, it's going to damage our Bridgmanite pillars. Got some cartilage here, too. Woo! I'm going to clear out all these little plants here because they're getting in the way. Oh, boy. Ouch. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh, yeah, baby. Getting pretty hectic up in here. 40 seconds left. I told you we were going to want to get some turrets up, man. I wasn't kidding. All right, let's see here. Sustenance. We get a little bit of health for this. Let's go and consume these real fast. All right, do we have anything else coming in? Yep, we sure do. Right over here. Don't let him get too close. Those are the quick guys. Whoa! Yeehaw! Smash him to the ground, baby. Oh, let's try and grab all this plasma fire before it explodes. There we go. We got quite a bit of it there. 18 plasma fire. Plasma fire is what we're going to use to build weaponry and the like. There you go. You can see everything kind of like spawning in. A new day, boys. A new day is here. We managed to survive the night. Guys, let me know what you think of Eden Star. This is just the beginning. This is like the simplest base you can possibly make realize. Very neat game, though. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know in the comment section below if you want to see me continue with it. I may continue regardless because I think this is a really neat game. Till the next time, folks, stay foxy and much love.